Back with us now, our panel, Andre Bauer, Van Jones, Anousheh Hussain, Evan McMullen, and Cedric Alexander. We heard some strong words from Governor Terry McAuliffe right off the bat. He says, I have a message to white supremacists and Nazis who came into Charlottesville today. Go home. He went on to say, you are not patriots. You came here today to hurt people. There is no place for you here. There is no place for you in America. Van, those words were clear and direct.
I think those were the words that a lot of people needed to hear and want to hear continually from the president, from the governor. And listen, there has to be a universal condemnation of the loudest sort. We now have three Americans dead. Listen, Andre says we don't have all the facts. I'm going to go out on a limb, and I'm going to say that the person who rammed into that crowd did so for political reasons. So it's an act of political terrorism. And I think it's going to be revealed that it was white supremacist terrorism. So one of the things that has to happen now, you now have three people who are dead, and there may be more. When Americans start being murdered and killed in our country for political reasons by Nazis, if that country can't come together on that, we are in deep trouble. There is no political downside, folks, to condemning Nazis killing Americans. I promise you, we're not that far gone. So this is the opportunity for us to come together, and the President of the United States should be leading the charge. If this president does not want to be sending dog signals and winks and nods to white supremacists and Nazis, this guy is one of the clearest communicators in the history of American politics. He should come out just as clear as the governor. If the governor can be that clear, the president should be more clear, because he's on the world stage and the whole world is watching. This is an absolute outrage. I don't get it. When you have someone who says, in one part of his speech, he loves everybody, there are now, it looks like, if you look online, that the Nazis are celebrating his speech. It's not been confirmed yet, but they're saying he's saying he loves us. He is not being clear enough. He's got to be more clear.
But Van, just to be fair for the president, he's not a white supremacist himself. Is he being held responsible, in a sense, for something he didn't have control over?
Hey, listen, if there were a Muslim terrorist attack, he's not a Muslim terrorist. If there were, people who love science fiction started blowing stuff up, he probably doesn't like science fiction. It doesn't matter what the terrorist is about. He has to condemn terrorism. He has to condemn extremism. And I don't understand why he feels like if it's a white supremacist group, he's got to tiptoe. He has more authority as somebody who is on the right to say there's a clean right and there's a dirty right. The clean right has ideas that I agree with. The dirty right traffics in violence and anti-Jewish bigotry and racism, and it has no place in my party, my movement, or my country. If he said that, it would shock these people back on their heels. The fact he hasn't said it, and the fact we now have three people dead and nothing